Growing up, these are the kinds of things people say to me. Hey, Hilman, I can't believe you watched this. It's for girls. Hey, Hilman, what properly body you walk like a girl? Hey, Hilman, you're a man. Have to act like one. Now, I would usually say, yeah, Mom. Good evening, Full Toastmasters, and welcome guests.
Good evening.
Growing up, I've always felt like a stick in a mud. I was a sissy boy. I've always felt different from the other boys at school. They have their own hobbies, I have mine. They joined sports club, I joined drama in the arts. They liked Jason Mraz and Bruno Mars, I enjoyed Katy Perry and Lady Gaga. They took guitar, I took piano. They liked girls, I... also, like girls, yes. Some things they have in common with boys. Really. Okay, maybe I'm exaggerating being feminine. I mean, I know I don't look like this.
Oh my god!
Yeah, I don't. There's nothing wrong with that, I just don't. I don't. Right? Right?
Yeah.
But I have been called names for having feminine traits, apparently. One time, a few years ago, I was volunteering at school, and I walked past this young male student. This young, charming gentleman, with his eloquent words, decided to shout to me, "Ewa! Nice strutting, girly!" And I was like, oh no, he didn't! I do not walk like a girl! I don't! Right? So anyways, I was so mad, I wanted to walk towards him and give him a beating or two. Unfortunately, I didn't. Because it's hard to walk with high heels. Hey, those inches matter, okay? Your first job, you gotta look professional. Point is, I've always felt different during growing up because I have feminine features and mannerisms, apparently. It's not like I never tried to fit in with other boys. I mean, I've tried sports. Me. Tried sports. Worst mistakes I've ever done. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I never get sports. A conversation would be like, hey man, you see that match the other day? Remember when that guy kicked the ball here and there running around? Oh, and remember that time when that guy kicked the ball and hit the goal? Classic, man. That's how I view sports. It's just a bunch of manly men kicking a ball for 2 hours. What's so fun about watching a bunch of sweaty, muscular, attractive men in shorts? Anyways, when I tried sport, it was a disaster because whenever my friends dragged me, I was like, oh no, it's so dirty, I don't want to get sweaty. Like, this is like very clean, I don't want to get this dirty, I just get my nails done. Needless to say, my team didn't win, and PE wasn't exactly my forte. But that's okay, I guess. That's not. In any case, yes, don't talk to me about sports, because I will not get it. Bro, what's your favorite football team? Bro, did you see that match with Manu and Chelsea the other night? Awesome, bro. See, and for me it's like, yes. Fascinating. It's just like how you talk to your girlfriends when she's talking to you. It's like, oh my god, do you like this dress? It's like, oh, let's go here. It's so interesting. And you're like, yes, I agree, Sam. It's the same thing, except instead of you saying bonus, replace it with whatever pet name you gave to your girlfriend. And speaking of the word bro, it's like the magical word ever. It's about everyone. Your best friend, hey, what's up, bro? Then your other friends, hey, bros, what's up? That guy who you work with but you don't talk to, hey, bro, can I borrow your pen? That person you just got ticked off, that ticked you off, hey, bro! That cat, hey, just meet my bro, the same for day. All the connectors of man. And it's so beneficial because it gets you off of awkward situations. Imagine, hey bro, happy Valentine's Day. Not so awkward, right? In any case, the point I'm trying to say is, I know it all seems sad, me looking back and not fitting in, but I did learn one thing from all those experiences. I pretended to like what I don't like, and that got me nowhere. I mean, but when I did join drama and arts and all that stuff, sure I had struggles here and there, but I met the most endearing people I've ever met. They've accepted me. And they have the same issues and struggles that I did, and I felt welcome. My main message here is to don't be afraid to love what you love. Because the biggest favor you can do to yourself is to be honest with yourself. Let me end my speech with this quote by Dr. Seuss. Be who you are and say what you feel. Because those who mind don't matter. And those who matter don't worry. Back to you.